This is the San Francisco of 1965, where 20 years ago, a group of nations gathered to form a world body that they hoped would outlaw war and bring brotherhood to all men. While the United Nations has fallen short of its ambitious goal, there are many reasons to mark its 20th birthday, a 20 years that have seen the UN halt some conflicts and head off others. Today, 113 nations, strife-torn Dominica is missing, meet at the Opera House where the charter was signed to mark a birthday and express hope for the future. On every hand, there is evidence of many of the United Nations' accomplishments. A painting commemorates the signing of the charter for the U.S. by Edward Stettinius as President Truman looks on, and nearby, the charter itself is displayed. On that June day in 1945, 50 nations who had fought the Axis powers affixed their signatures to the charter that is the basis for the United Nations. This was the result of 63 days of conferences and parleys. And in those days of optimism, there were few who did not think that this was the basis for a peaceful future among nations. Mr. Truman had become president not long before the charter writing conference began, while World War II was still raging in Europe and in the Pacific. On this historic June day, he warned that we would betray all those who died on the battlefields if the world failed to use the newly created machinery for peace. That the United Nations has had both successes and failures is now a matter of history. On that same platform, 20 years later, another president of the United States stands to plead the cause of the United Nations still further. President Johnson addresses a body that has been torn by dissension, that is facing a continuing financial crisis, but which still remains man's one great hope in world affairs. The president appealed to the UN to renew its efforts to bring about peace in Southeast Asia, and he called upon all men to stop preaching hatred. He went on to say that younger generations must stop believing that the gun or the bomb can solve all problems, adding that we must succeed where past generations have failed.
And I do know this. Whether we look for the judgment to God or to history or to mankind, this is the age, and we are the men. And this is the place to give reality to our commitments under the United Nations Charter. For what was for other generations just a hope, it is for this generation a simple necessity. Thank you very much.
The applause Mr. Johnson's talk receives is but an echo of the hope men have that the United Nations will weather the crises ahead, as it has been able to do in the past. There is no way of truly knowing what bloody conflicts have been averted, been rationalized at UN conference tables. After Secretary General Outhant presented Mr. Johnson with a medal commemorating the occasion, the two men held an hour-long talk on methods of finding a peaceful solution to the South Vietnam War. In the UN, men of goodwill find hope. Without it, the world's future could be a question mark.